Hello, hello, I'm Li Hao. So it's Svelte question time. You have any questions? I have answers for you. So today's question is, can you call a function inside a component from the outside? So can you, if your component has a function, can you call it from the outside? Say for example, if I have a component called dialog and have a function to open the dialog, can I, from outside the dialog, call this function? So what do you think? Can't you call a function inside a component? Well, let's take a look at the answer. The answer is yes, and we're gonna take a look how we're gonna do it. So here I've prepared an example. As I said, I created a dialog component. Here, the dialog component has this prop called isProp open, which I can close and open using these two buttons over here. So in this dialog component, I have a props called isOpen and some states, the name and email, right? So I have, so if the open is true, I will show the dialog and also have names and some forms over here where I can type. So here I have a close button, which when I click it, it will call the close model, which will set the isOpen to false and resets the form. So for example, if I come over here and type something and I click close and when I try to open again, oh wait, something is wrong over here. Okay, let me close and open. So when I open again, you will see that this form is resetted, right? So is this being done by close model? But if you close from outside, so over here, if I say something like this, we close from outside and it opens, realize that the form is not reset because we only change the props call isOpen, right? When we change, we close and open, we change this state, it will only close and opens the dialog, but it's not going to reset our form, right? So there's two, there's one problem over here that we saw just now. When we try to close this button, we realize that when you close, when you kind of click open, it does not open it. That's because this open, right, is a props where we change, it's a props and a state at the same time. And we change the value as a state of this state to false when we close the button. But from the outside, we didn't do a two-way binding. So this variable is still true, but internally in the dialog, it stays false. Right? So when you try to set a variable true to which itself is already a true, then you kind of, nothing has happened because you try to set a variable to a value that is already is, right? You set a variable that is true to true, Svelte will not entertain that. Nothing has happened. So what we can do here is try to do a two-way data binding. We bind isOpen to this variable called isOpen. Now when we set the variable from inside, when we set it to false from inside, the variable outside will also turn to false as well. So when I try to set something true to something false to true, it will open up the form, right? So this kind of fix this. But we haven't deal with this where we have a form. When we kind of close and open, it's not resetted. But if you close here and open it, you realize the form is resetted. So one way you can do is maybe come over here and have, say, a reactive statement. If it's is open is false, then we want to do something like a close model. Sorry, not close model, but reset, right? So this is one way you can do it. Close, open, it's resetted. But this is not that nice because you change is open from outside and inside, but from inside, we change it with the close model, which already called reset, right? So we don't want to call this reset twice over here where when you close model, when you set it to false, you call it reset, and here you call it reset again, right? We don't want to call this reset twice. Or what we want is there a way that we can have this function called close model to be called from the outside of this component, which is what I'm going to share with you today, which is how you can do a component method. So the answer is yes, and we can do this. And first is, how do we get like the instance of this component, Well, we're going to use a bind this, right? So you can have a variable called dialog, and we can bind this dialog component instance to this variable called dialog. So this is step number one. Use a bind this to bind this component instance to a variable. Next, step two is we need to export these functions, like much like you're exporting a props. So you can export this function, close model, over here. So you use export function, close model. Now this function itself is being exported. You can call this function from outside, like a method of the instance. So here I can have, when I click close, I can say dialog, because I already have the instance to this dialog component, and I can say close model. I'll call this function like as if it's a method of this instance of this component. I call close model. So here, if I try to type something, when I click close model and open, you'll realize that the form is being resetted. We can also export this function called isReset. Oh wait, I think we need to comment this to actually prove that it works, right? So we're gonna type again, close model and opened. Yep, it's being resetted, right? So we can also export this function called reset. And maybe somehow we have buttons that we can use to reset the dialog. Reset. And here we're gonna call resets method from this dialog. Again, we export a function inside your component, and it will turn into a method of your component instance. So here, type something and click reset. It will reset the form for me, right? So one last try. I'm gonna come over here and say export function open model. And this does nothing but just set open to true. And here now I can come over here and get this instance, component instance, dialog.openModel. And now I don't even need to bind this open props. I can call all the component methods to open and close this props, right? So here I don't even need to expose it. So here it's open. Okay, by default it's true. Here I can close, open, and resets the form, reset the dialog, right? So here you go. Here's how you can expose functions as if they are like component, to become a component methods for your components. And so two steps. First, bind this to get the instance of a component, and then use the component instance to call functions. So to call methods, and those methods, you have to expose them by using export function. Expose them so that you can use it as a component method. So that's all for this video. If you have any questions, feel free to comment down below. If you like this video, give me a thumbs up. And as always, subscribe to my channel so that you get notified when the next one is out. So see ya, bye bye.